Santa, what the hell?
That's not my house!
Bullshit.
Oh, bro, I couldn't afford a place like that. I'm a tennis coach. I hit balls for a living. I was just hiding there.
Give me a phone! You! You're a dead one! Green light! Green light! Martin Madrazo, give you green light!
Oh, I'm scared, lady. Just fucking terrified.
Green light! Green light! Martin Madrazo! Fuck you!
Whoa! Home. Martin? Martin Madrazo?
That's what she said.
Damn, dude's a kingpin, homie. And you better hope. Hey, man, that's some mean-looking motherfucking essays right behind you.
Oh, that was quick.
All right, help me deal with this. I give it a go, man. Keep driving.
Come on, kid.
Hey, let's go. Let's leave them behind.
All right, we managed to lose them?
We got a book, man. Go!
You gotta use that gun?
Push the pedal, man. We gotta move.
Huh? How you doing, Frank?
Let's go! Let's leave them behind!
Shit, man! Get rid of them!
We got a book, man! Go!
All right, all right!
There you go! Push the pedal, man! We gotta move!
Can you see them? Are they still back there?
Be careful!
Fuck, man! These assholes are mean!
Come on, kid!
This is a misunderstanding, motherfucker!
Where are we on this?
I think you slipped, man.
All right, let's go back.
Wow. Shit. You did good. I mean, your aim's all over the place, but you were a help.
Thanks. I guess.
Hey, don't get defensive. Go to a shooting range. Work on your aim. You'll do fine.
Oh, fuck, man. Shit, you good?
Fine as wine. Got a few knocks. You okay? I mean, you did good, kid.
Man, I'm cool, man. I mean, you. Mentally.
Mentally? Oh, man. I'm fucking excellent. My heart ain't pumped like that in years. Oh, yes! Fucking A, Bubba!
Man, you sound kind of manly. You just been greenlit by the Mexican underworld ambassador to Los Santos.
Trust me, we handled it. Whoever the fuck Martin Madrazo is, I've known worse.
We just handled a few low-ranking crimes.
We sit on it, we see what happens. Kid, there's no use second-guessing. Felt good, man.
Woo!
Yeah, doing something for a change. Ha!
Man, you know what? You are wasted sitting by that fucking fool, man.
You're right. I need to do something. Scotch and sunshine is sitting on my ass. Fuck that. I'm better than that.
Damn Skippy, homie. All that knowledge up there is withering and dying, dawg. You don't pass that shit on, it's gone, homie. I bet you know some shit.
You wouldn't believe the shit I know.
Yeah? You taking some scores?
There was a time, that was all I did.
Shit, well, you know, I could tell you some shit, too.
Yeah, like what?
About this city I was born and raised in.
Now think about it.
Yeah, do that, man. This could be cool.
Whew. Hey, thanks for the help out there today, kid. I had no idea it was gonna get that hot.
Shit, pulling houses off the hillside sure has a weird way of fucking with people.
Yeah, well, I thought I was through with all that shit. I don't know what the hell's going on.
Oh, shit, I think we're about to find out.
Do you know who I am?
Do you know who I am?
Do you?
No.
No, you? You?
I think so.
Good.
I know who you are. I know where you live. Who are you?
I'm Franklin.
License. Now, Franklin, maybe help Mr. DeSanta here. Who am I?
I think Martin Madrazo.
Good boy. Now maybe give him a little of a background.
Man, Mr. Madrazo... Mr. Madrazo is a legitimate businessman who was wrongfully accused of running a Mexican-American gang and a narcotic ring, but the charges were dropped because of the witnesses came up missing.
Smart kid. Now, Michael, got a question for you.
Did you pull an architectural, significant, modernist wonder home down the hillside in Vinewood Hills?
I thought the owner was banging my wife.
Well, that was a strange house for a tennis coach.
I wasn't thinking straight.
Clearly.
Yeah.
Well, Natalia will need a hotel while you finance the rebuild, won't she?
Sure.
Good. And I'm guessing here that the rebuild will be somewhere in the 2.5 million range?
Of course.
Great.
That's nice.
Come on, man. Damn, you all right?
Never better.
So what now?
Looks like I'm gonna have to postpone my retirement. Fuck. Ah, man, I'm mortgaged up to my eyeballs. Look, I only know one way to make money. I'm gonna have to give an old friend a call. Lester. I think he's in town somewhere. I'm gonna have to track him down. Just give me a little alone time, all right?
All right, dawg.
Fuck, man.
Hello. Is this still the number for Lester Crest?
Who's asking?
Who's asking? Who's asking?
You're awful cagey. Even for a dead man, Michael.
Ooh, you don't sound good, buddy.
Tactful and charming, even in death. Hey, come see me, old friend. I'm living in Los Santos, just like you. Marietta Heights.
Whoa, wait. Hey, how do you... Hello? You fucker.
Speak 160 languages on 6 continents, including Antarctica.
Kiflam.
We are the Epsilon Program.
We apologize for discovering this cool music before you did. Radio Mirror Park.
Doc, hey.
Michael, I'm looking through my appointment book and I don't see your name.
Yeah, well, I'm more of a walk-in guy, Doc. You know that.
Walk-ins are more expensive, but I'm always happy to accommodate.
Sure, you'll accommodate me as long as I got money in my pocket, right? Hey, I'm in a bad way, Doc. I might come by soon.
Seismologists did not notice any unusual activity, and the house passed inspection just last year. Melinda Manchester is at the scene.
This homeowner is obviously distraught.
Leave me alone! I don't want to talk to biased American media!
We'll stay on this story. A group of vigilantes calling themselves the Civil Border Patrol are attempting to combat the illegal immigration in San Andreas's Alamo Sea region. Police and liberal commentators have both attempted to make the group stop its actions, but so far to no avail.
We've long known that actors are empty and vapid, and so are the high-tech rooms where most movies are made these days. Thanks to cheap overseas animation houses, the days of filming on location are coming to an end as CG takes over. Richard's Majestic recently... that two new films in production will be filmed almost entirely on green screen. Meltdown, a Vinewood retelling of the financial crisis set in Liberty City, and Deep Inside, a globe-trotting derivative spy thriller, are both being shot in Los Santos.
The new iFruit phone won't be available for 3 months, but some losers are lining up already. We stopped outside the iFruit store and spoke with Sean Douglas, who says he can't wait.
This next phone's going to be the future. And finally show those losers with their drone phones who is the king.
Some commentators say that iFruit's glory days are behind it as cheap clones flood the market and people remember it's only a phone anyway. We'll stay on this story as we literally have no interest in covering the real ones happening at home and
confirming your prejudices. This is for people just like you. Individuals. Radio Mirror Park.
Human soul to create something as majestic as an eye.
Come in, Michael.
Yeah, thanks, Doc.
How have you been?
Oh, good. Things been good. No, actually, things ain't been good. Things been a far fucking way from good. I've been acting out. That's what you would call it, I think, right? Acting out.
So what exactly has been the problem?
I'm not good, Doc. Not good at all.
I'm sorry to hear that. Tell me.
I don't know. I guess we've been having these conversations long enough that I can recognize a trigger when I see one. You know? Shit that's gonna put me right over the fucking edge. Like my family. My son, my daughter, my wife, especially my wife. I mean, they just set me right off, Doc. You know, there's been this episode. You know, actually, it was a culmination of a series of episodes. I pulled this Mexican's house right off the fucking hill. I mean, I think I'm back in it, Doc. I'm back into life. I mean, I gotta make some money, and there's only a couple ways I know how to do it.
You feel the need to explain your decisions, Michael. Take responsibility. So, any other violent urges, friend?
I ain't been a good boy, Doc. I mean, you know, things just all of a sudden get up on top of me, right fucking on top. And then I lose my shit, and I hurt people, and then I feel bad about it. I'm a fucking prick.
Remorse is good, but not as good as taking control before you act out.
I really just want to be happy, Doc. Is that so bad?
Okay. And what about your sexual behaviors?
I've been a really good boy, Doc. Really good. Not one problem.
I'm glad to hear that. Really glad. Keep working it. This is great.
I just ain't myself right now, Doc. Not since my life went crazy.
You're plainly addicted to chaos.
Well, I'm not sure that's true, Doc. I'm not exactly enjoying myself here. Now, what I'm addicted to is not getting killed. But for some reason, I keep getting my ass into situations where getting killed is a little hard to avoid.
What about the people you kill?
Well, yeah, but that's not for fun.
Are you sure?
What exactly are you asking, Doc? Am I a psychopath who enjoys suffering? Or a sociopath who doesn't give a flying fuck about the rules? Come on, we've already had this conversation, right? I'm neither. I'm just a fat, washed-up jock who can't get his head around the fact that his high school football career didn't play out the way that he planned. The only way I'm content and competent is with a gun in my hand or a price on my head.
You're very defensive, Michael. Do you consider yourself a failure?
I pay you to listen to my problems. I'm rich. I'm miserable. I mean, half the time my kids can't stand me. The other half, my wife is cheating on me. I kill people without remorse, Doc. Hell, I'm pretty average for this town, really.
Wait a minute, that's the shot. I think I'm having a breakthrough here, Doc. I know that I'm just terrified that I'm
sure you are, but that's really all we have time for. See you next time.
Okay.
Give it up! Make it easy on yourself!
Oh.